two air strikes, targeting two different sites, north and south of Gaza, in the early hours of Thursday. Medical sources said that four people were injured when a rocket hit a site in Tufah neighborhood north of Gaza City. The strike caused loud explosion and left damage to nearby police station and residential houses.
At around 2 in the morning, a loud explosion rocked our area. My arm sustained traction when I was thrown against the wall because the blast was very powerful. Children started to cry, and as you can see, smashed glass is everywhere.
The Israeli army said that the strikes came in response to homemade rockets fired from the seaside territory, holding Hamas-ruled Gaza responsible for any such acts. As Israel continues to control Gaza's airspace, territorial waters, and border crossings, internationally pro-Palestine activists are planning to organize different events in the coming months to show solidarity with besieged Gazans. Activists say that it is important for international observers to come to Palestine in general, and Gaza in particular, which has been under Israeli siege for over 5 years, in order to help get the story out and make the voice of the long-suffering Palestinians heard worldwide.
There will always be flotillas, convoys, land convoys being organized, demonstrations like at the moment there are demonstrations in solidarity with Khadr Adnan in Europe, in Ireland, north and south, and all over Europe. So the people of Europe are definitely on the side of the Palestinians.
The flotillas are a vital part of the whole struggle for Gaza and for the Palestinians. It highlights the whole story of Palestine and the suffering that the Palestinians are going through.
Meanwhile, coordinators of siege breaking boats say that the economic situation in Gaza has not improved, as Israel still imposes restrictions on imports and exports. In May 2010, 9 Turkish activists were killed by Israeli commandos when the Mavi Marmara, an aid ship bound for Gaza, was raided in international waters.
There will be the flotilla, which thousands of the international activists will try to come to Palestine through the different airports in Europe and in America. In the same time, there will be another initiative from the sea. Tens of boats will try to come to break the siege in Gaza.
Israel has continued to impose a total closure on the occupied Palestinian territories and has isolated the Gaza Strip from the outside world. Yusuf Al-Hilo, Press TV, Gaza.